Hi team, welcome. With macOS Sequoia now out since September, we've seen quite a few security improvements in the later beta builds. Whilst this is an overall net improvement, it can cause a few headaches when it comes to installing third-party applications on your machine. Today, we're going to run you through a few different methods to install unapproved, damaged, and unsigned applications. If there's a certain method you want to skip to, use the chapter markers below. The issue. Here I have an application that I've downloaded from the internet. When I attempt to double-click and open it, I get the following prompt on my machine. This prompt can come in a variety of flavors, but will likely mention that it can't be verified or the app itself is damaged. Whilst I am going to show you ways to get around this, it's extremely important that the program you're attempting to launch is intended for your machine, and that it doesn't pose any security issues. Manually approve. The quickest and easiest method is to try to manually allow launching the application. All you need to do is head into System Settings, Privacy and Security, and click Open Anyway. You may be prompted a few times for your admin password. To skip this process in future, we're going to use Terminal to allow third-party app installs. Open Terminal and type the following command, also in the description. After typing in your password, go into System Settings. You'll now be able to change the toggle to allow installations from anywhere. Terminal. The next thing is to try whitelist the application with Terminal. First, we need to give full disk access to Terminal. Go to your System Settings and into Privacy and Security. Next, click Full Disk Access and make sure the slider is toggled on for Terminal. Next, type in the following command, which is also in the description. At the end of the string, drag your installer into the terminal window. Make sure the file is saved locally and not on a network drive or mounted. Enter your password, and that's it. Try to open the application again. Sentinel. The most up-to-date method is to disable Gatekeeper and sign the application yourself. Whilst this sounds complicated, this is all done with one simple program. Head to the link in the description and download the app Sentinel, choosing whatever the latest release is. Next, extract the downloaded application and drag it to your Applications folder. Next, open Sentinel and the folder where your installer is. Drag the application to the first drop point to remove the app from quarantine, and then the second drop point to sign it yourself. You can just choose one option, but ensure Gatekeeper is turned off from the jump. Now you should be free to install the application. Thanks again for watching. Don't hesitate to leave a comment if you have any suggestions for future content or questions. Hopefully myself or someone else can help. Please make sure to give this video a thumbs up if it was helpful, and we'll catch you in the next one.